that happiness and that kind of funky, whatever that was, I don't know, I'm just messing around in D, does not, thankfully, reflect my mood of today. Today, I don't know, one of the more brutal days of the year. A lot of nonsense going on that I won't bore you to tears with and won't get into it in the vlog, but I also will share something with you which happened today that wasn't that great, which was, and I can't believe I'm about to say this, and anyone watching the vlog is gonna go, are you serious? Like, for real? And anyone who's been watching the vlog for a while, my storage locker got knocked over again. I can't believe I'm saying it. As much as some of you, like, regular viewers and followers and that may be thinking, scratching your head, I'm really scratching my head, my elbow, my chin, like, really? So yeah, that was 11 a.m. this morning, in the middle of an already pretty hectic day and not a lot of sleep last night because the DVD shoot yesterday went really well. That's why I'm here making a video about this base, because somebody mentioned in the comments, I forget who it was, but I took a quick browse through the comments and somebody said, hey, why don't you make a make a vlog about the Fodera, kind of Fodera's answer to the P base, which is this, I think in Monarch something or the other. The title of this video will display the correct name for this base, but it's basically Fodera's answer to the P base. And I really gravitated towards it yesterday. In it, for some reason, I took a bunch of basses with me, like I said in yesterday's vlog, and the P bass with the flats, the Fender, and you know, the Mayones with the low B, and both of which are amazing instruments and which I've played a bunch before. And then it was really this one that spoke to me once I got in the room, and that was cool. It was not the coolest part of the day, because the coolest part of the day was actually getting all that stuff filmed and compiled and really in this beautiful flow for you guys. That was the coolest thing, but this was a really nice bonus to kind of get a moment with an instrument that I totally wasn't expecting. I think that was really cool about it. I've had this bass for a couple of years, almost 2 years, and I did use it. When I first got it, I used it to make my last DVD, The Practice Routine Volume 1. And that was great, but it was in a small space and it was at a low volume. And at Jimmy V's crib yesterday, I was able to really, you know, give it the beans and give it some volume and really kind of feel and experience the bass for the first time. So I think it's gonna be coming out of the house with me a little more. Maybe I'll try playing it on a couple of Bob Reynolds gigs coming up this month and next month. Who knows? Like, all of these influences kind of flash by all at once, you know, all these Jameson things and Duck Dunn things and Pino Palladino things, just like all my favorite people from that kind of way of playing. And it's got that kind of, I don't know what it is, it's got that little kind of extra thing, that little extra bit of class, I think, or maybe workmanship, or maybe it's because it's a slightly more modern bass, it doesn't feel like a P bass exactly like the older Fender ones, and I kind of feel like it has that little bit more richness, maybe, in the upper register. Not that I really play the upper register on this bass so much. With the tone kind of rolled all the way off. Inspiring is what it is. I gotta say, that's probably the best word to use, because I'm playing all these lines that I don't normally play. I kind of wish I had a band around me right now, a drummer and like a super funky guitar player and a keyboard player who really knows how to play Rhodes. That would be really fun. Maybe I've got to kind of inject some more funk and kind of R&B influences into Bob's gig. That's kind of my only live outlet with a band right now, and kind of get that thing happening. Who knows? It's just, it is inspiring, and it's great. It was great yesterday to have that connection with the instrument, and definitely kind of made me a little more aware of it and a little more inclined to pick it up off the stand and practice with it. and just... And get used to it as well. Like, I don't know the instrument really well enough to say that I have complete command of it yet. But it's a totally different feeling. It is that Fender P bass feeling. It's that passive thing. I've got the Aguilar. I think these are the vintage P bass pickups. I'm not 100% sure. I don't know. That's the other thing. I don't know too much about the bass other than the one DVD I shot before, the thing I did yesterday, and now today really kind of getting into it. And it's awesome to have instruments and to really know what each of those instruments, what their place is in your sound. I think if you have multiple instruments but you gravitate towards one more than the rest, kind of like I do for sure with the regular Fodera, with the five string, with the high C, I definitely play that more than any other instrument right now. But it's so good, and it has been so good the last couple of days to find this and to really say, oh, that's where that belongs in the arsenal. These are the things that I would take that out on the road for, or for a gig, or for a recording session, or just to practice at home. Like, you see me in the beginning of today's vlog, I'm just grooving. You know, it's so much fun to do that. Working out which things sing out more, where I can play chords, where I can play double stops, kind of if there are any spots on the neck that are a little funky, maybe I have to have them looked at and adjusted, or maybe I actually like that, and that's something that's going to inspire me to play slightly differently, have a different approach with the right hand, different kind of pressure with the right hand. So even with the tone rolled all the way up, so it's at its kind of brightest, I can still get a huge round sound the more I play up to the fingerboard. And then take it all the way off. And somewhere in the middle, there's no notch, but somewhere in the middle. Definitely take me a while of playing it. I'll have to dedicate some time to it, you know, to really flesh it out. And yesterday on the DVD, I was using my Miura M2 compressor and the Noble Pre, like this combination, deadly combination, I gotta say. In fact, let's go triple threat. That right there, that was the deadly combination on the session yesterday. Kind of super happy to have had all of that available to me. So good to be able to be aware when you're doing something under pressure like that, like recording something for yourself, and you're the producer and the writer and the arranger and the bass player and the band leader, and you're the one like ordering the lunch, just doing everything, to be able to be aware, like, okay, at some point I need to stop. I need to have my little checklist of things that I need to check off. And okay, sound check is definitely one of them. Is everything in tune? Yes. Is the instrument intonated well? So you know, especially playing chords yesterday, so they're all really nicely in tune all over the instrument. Those little details that are super easy to get overlooked. And those are things that I used to overlook in a big way. I think that has a lot to do with why the first few albums I went in the studio to record to try and release as my debut solo album did not work out, because I was trying to do way too much. And even though I think the music was pretty good on the whole, and the musicians were exceptional, I was working with some amazing musicians, I think I was a little too stressed out and not aware enough of what was going on around me to know when to like dial it back, slow down, take everything in, and really think about, okay, what's so important here? What's the most important thing? And of course, the most important thing is, well, I think, I was gonna say the music, but the most important thing is are those people around you, and how you manage them, and how you direct them and encourage them, and how you draw the performance out of them. I think that's, you know, it's the job of a great producer, is to work with people and to get the best possible performance out of a musician. I think I was worrying about way too many things and not concentrating enough on my role as a producer and on my role as a musician within that production. So that's definitely something I've learned way more about over the years, not only working on my own records, but I've, you know, spent some time in the trenches there producing so much, well, just so much music, and so much different music in New York various studios in Manhattan and also out in New Jersey for a few real intense years there, working as a producer and just being in the studio, being around those situations and learning enough about them to be like, oh yeah, this is really important. That's not so important, as nice as that might be as a detail. These are the important things, and these are the things I'm going to remember to go to first on a session. So we started out talking about the Fodera, and we ended up talking about recording and producing music. But the two, I think, are quite related, because one of those things is, which instrument do you take to the studio to use? You know, is it your music? Is it someone else's music? What style of music is it? Are you as inspired or as comfortable as I might be with this instrument right now? I think my inspiration level is super high. I think my comfort level with the instrument is not quite as high as that. So it would definitely be a consideration when I was making a choice to take this instrument to a session. Like, what does the session require of me? What does the music require of me? Can I execute all of that in complete comfort and relaxation on this instrument? And if it's, you know, something simple and something grooving and something funky, absolutely, no problem. Off I go. Is it something a little more complex? Maybe I take an instrument that I'm a little more comfortable with and I don't have to think about any technical elements of the instrument. So all of those things go into planning so many elements of production and organization when it comes to music. And having just done that epic recording session yesterday for the DVD, it's fresh in my mind, as is this awesome bass. Just something today that really turned me on about this bass. I'm very, very happy to share that moment with you. And for that to be the dominant force in a day which has just been like heading down the toilet, basically, in all other areas. It's really, I feel so fortunate to have this. I mean, to have Chelsea and to have be healthy and those things, but also to have something like this. My music, an instrument, just some form of inspiration, to have you guys to talk to about this. Like I keep saying, very therapeutic. I appreciate that very much. So although today was a bit of a massive train wreck in kind of most areas, there's definitely light at the end of the tunnel. I appreciate you guys being here to come along for the ride. I hope you dug checking out this bass a little more and taking a little listen kind of a little more in depth and a little closer. And the feel is so different from all of my other instruments as well. The action is, it's not that low, it's not that high. Check that out. It's kind of medium-ish, I guess. I guess I would raise it a little bit more. I think I would be scuffing up a little less if I had the action a little higher. See there, getting dug into the string a little bit too much. So it's things like that, and it's when I make a little mistake like that and kind of dig into the string too much, that's when I kind of recalibrate and try not to repeat that mistake. Those are the kinds of things I'm conscious of when I'm practicing in general, but especially when, and I hate to say, this instrument is like over a year and a half old to me, and it's still a relatively new instrument. So that's kind of my process for getting to know it a little better. Kind of the position of the pickup and where I can bounce off the pickup and where I really have to be conscious of not letting my finger get under the string the further back or the further forward I go. Just those little details. Anyway, that's enough of me. That's enough of the bass. Enough nonsense from today. Thank you for watching. Thank you for sticking around, guys. Cannot tell you how much I appreciate that. Today's vlog is done, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Thank you.
Thank you.